In this world today, there are many ways to fall from grace and to go astray.
واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. ويقول لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد, all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah Almighty, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. And I encourage myself and you to fear no one but Allah, as Allah your Lord states in the Holy Quran, all those who believe, fear Allah. Fear Allah the way he should be feared, and do not die unless you're in the state of Islam and grab tight unto the rope of Allah Azza wa Jalla united, and do not divide. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, all those who believe, fear Allah and say what's straight and correct. Allah Azza wa Jalla in return will forgive your sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will correct your actions. And those who obey Allah and His Messenger had no doubt succeeded great success in this world, and no doubt in the hereafter. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take people away from the darkness to the light of Islam, and to take people away from the worship of the creation to the worship of the Creator, Allah Almighty, and from the injustice of all religions to the justice of Islam and the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam, as what the scholars define, it's aqeedah, creed, ibadah, worship, akhlaq, wasuluk, manners and discipline. Islam, once again, has three important components. Aqeedah, creed, belief. Having the correct belief in Allah Azza wa Jal, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordained us to believe in. Ibadah, worship. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He wants us to worship Him, not the way we want to worship Him. And thirdly, akhlaq wa suluk, manners, morals, ethics, and discipline. And I believe this ummah, alhamdulillah, in the majority, have the right aqeedah and creed and believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they worship Allah Azza wa Jal correctly. But there's one thing that we lack in our lives, is we lack the manners and the morals of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have an issue in this ummah. We have great shortcomings towards our religion. We have crises in our religion. And what's our crisis now is manners and morals. Not acting like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Not behaving like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Not thinking like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Not having the manners and the morals of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, when he himself, he says, "Bu'ithtu li'utammima makarim al-akhlaq." He says about himself, I was sent to perfect and complete the noble manners. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes it clear that one of his main purposes and objectives of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending him into this world is that he perfects and completes the good manners and morals of people. Islam is not just prayers. Islam is not just fasting. Islam is not just paying zakat and performing hajj and reading the Quran al-Karim and praying on the dead. But Islam is a lot more broader than that. Islam is about how you behave. Islam is about how you act. Islam is how you portray Islam, in particular in a country that we live in a non-Muslim Western country. Salah, siyam, zakat, hajj, and other important parts of Islam are very important. But as it is important for me to pray, and important for me to fast, and important for me to pay zakat, and important for me to go to hajj, it is also important for me to have the best of manners and the best of morals and discipline, and that is the manners of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم says, عرضت علي الأعمال فما رأيت عملا أثقل في ميزان عند الله من حسن الخلق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed me all the good deeds. Allah showed the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam all the good deeds. And what every good deed gets in return of the rewards. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and after I've seen all the good deeds from the salah, from the siyam, from the zakat, from hajj, from umrah, from pain, from donating, from reading the Quran, he says, I did not see anything more heavier on the scale than the good manners. Nothing more heavier to Allah. Nothing more heavier to Allah on the scale than the good manners, the good akhlaq, the good morals, the good ethics, the good discipline. And when we talk about morals, what do we mean by that? It means how you deal with others. And please understand, manners is how you deal with others. It's not how you deal with yourself only, not only how you deal with your family, it's not only how you deal with Muslims, it is how you deal with others, with non-Muslims, even the animals. That's manners to us as Muslims. It's how you deal with others, whether to be yourself, your family, your neighbors, your friends, your cousins, your kids, your Muslim brothers and sisters, the non-Muslim people, even the animals. This is Islam, having the best of manners and morals. He alayhi salatu wasalam also says that someone with their good manners, you with your good manners, with your good akhlaq, with your good morals, can surpass the one that prays the night and fasts during the day in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone with his good manners, with his good morals, the way he deals with others, the way he speaks to others, with his generosity, with his kindness, with his gentleness, with his wisdom, with his forbearing, with his foresighting, with his dealings with others, he could be better than the one that prays the night and fasts during the day with good manners. With good manners. Yes, with good manners. Haven't we heard when a man comes to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and he says to him, oh messenger of Allah, I want to tell you about this woman. She prays the night. She fasts during the day. She gives a lot for the sake of Allah. She donates a lot. She reads the Quran. But then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, but she will be punished in the hellfire. Oh messenger of Allah, we are telling you about a woman that prays the night, fast during the day, pays her zakat, and she donates and she reads the Quran. Why would she be casted in the hellfire? In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, كَانَتْ تُؤْذِي جِيرَانَهَا. She was harmful and cruel towards her neighbors. What about the salah? Yes, it's heavy. What about the siyam? Yes, it's heavy on the scale. What about the zakat? Yes, it's heavy on the scale. What about the Quran? Yes, it's something great. But that's not enough if you don't have the best of manners. Because once again, what's Islam? Aqeedah, ibadah, akhlaq, wa suluk. Creed. Islam is creed, worship, and manners and morals. We focus on the first two, we neglect the third one. As if it's not important. When it is as important as it is to the first one and the second one. Then later on, another man comes to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, mentions a lady in front of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. She's an average prayer, she's an average faster, so she prays normal, she fasts normal, she's not like the previous woman that prays the night, fasts during the day, donates a lot. This is an average woman, prays her 5 daily prayers, she fasts her Ramadan, she gives when she can. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, وَلَكِنَّهَا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. She is from the people of the Jannah. Why, O Messenger of Allah? Because she was generous to her neighbors. Subhanallah. Generosity to your neighbor, Muslim or non-Muslim here, is a means to enter the Jannah. Kindness to people is a means that will make you enter the Jannah. Having the best of manners to others is a means to obtain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's paradise. Manners! This is what Islam is about. perfect a good manners of people. That's why he was sent. Not only to perfect our creed and perfect our salah and perfect our ibadah, that's one of it, and also to perfect our manners and morals. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal did not praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as much as he did praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his good manners. His good manners. وَإِنَّكَ, this is ta'keed, confirmation and asserting. Allah says, verily and indeed, O Muhammad, you are above. Not that you have, you are above the great manners as Allah describes him. Akhlaq, morals, discipline, ethics. Akhlaq Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, it is the manners and the morals of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that attracted his followers to him. It is the manners of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that turned the hatred to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam in Islam, into love. It is the manners of the Prophet والسلام, that he attracted his enemies to be his followers. It is the manners of the Prophet Muhammad والسلام, that made those who used to fight against him to fight with him. This is the manners of the Prophet Muhammad. This is the morals of the Prophet. Many people during the time of the Prophet والسلام, embraced Islam because they saw the manners of the Prophet والسلام, and they knew this is the manners of a prophet. Khalid ibn al-Walid. Khalid ibn al-Walid, this man that he says about himself, I broke and bent my sword by killing both of the Muslims. Khalid ibn Walid is that man that he says about himself, I broke so many swords by killing Muslims. He had so much hatred to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to Islam. And after the Hudaybiyah Treaty, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will agree with the people of Quraysh that he comes the following year and performs Umrah, him and the companions. In return, that the people of Quraysh and the leaders of Quraysh empty the Kaaba for the Muslims to perform Umrah. Now, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with thousands of his followers, come from Medina to Mecca to perform Umrah. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will sight and watch, and he will see many of the leaders of Quraysh. But there's one person amongst them that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't see, and that was Khalid ibn Walid. So on the way back from Mecca to Medina, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will speak to the brother of Khalid ibn Walid. His name is Al-Walid ibn Walid. And Al-Walid ibn Walid was one of the followers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, even though his brother is one of the most severest enemy to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this did not stop the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the manners of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and his morals and his rahmah, that Allah says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Verily have the best of manners, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad, we sent you a mercy to mankind. The rahmah and the mercy of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam did not stop him from asking about Khalid ibn Walid. So he asked his brother Al-Walid ibn Walid about his brother Khalid ibn Walid. Oh Walid, I saw all the leaders of Quraysh, but I did not see your brother Khalid. Where was he? So Al-Walid responds to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he says to him, O Messenger of Allah, my brother Khalid hates you so much that he could not stand watching you performing Umrah around the Kaaba. He hates you so much. He's got this hatred and grudge towards you that he could not even bear to see you doing the Umrah and the Kaaba. That's why he left Mecca, when he knew that you are coming to Mecca. Look at how much hatred in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's Abu Khalid ibn Walid. So what did the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam reply back? Did he reply back and respond back with hatred as we do and say, may Allah tell him, curse him, destroy him? No. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's rahmah played a big role at that time. To who? To Khalid ibn Walid. Who is Khalid ibn Walid? Khalid ibn Walid is the one of the most people who hated Islam. He would not even hesitate to kill the Prophet. So what did the Prophet say to his brother after his brother told him, "Oh, Messenger of Allah, my brother Khalid hates you so much"? So Nabi Sallallahu he says, "I am amazed. I am amazed to your brother Khalid. I see him a man with a lot of wisdom. But the only thing that amazes me about him is yet that he has not become a Muslim." Look at those wise words. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't curse him. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't make dua on him. Because he was not sent to make dua on people. He was sent to make dua for people. So he says, "I'm amazed to your brother Khalid. Someone with a lot of wisdom, that I see wisdom in him, yet he has not become a Muslim to this day." So his brother Walid took advantage of those wise words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he wrote a letter to his brother Khalid in Mecca, and then Khalid received that letter. Then Khalid received that letter, and he sees in that letter that the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam the other day was asking about you, and he said about you, "I am amazed to someone like Khalid, someone I see with a lot of wisdom, and yet he has not become Muslim." Islam entered his heart, so he came running to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to see the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and embrace Islam and say, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh." My brothers and sisters in Islam, what turned the hatred into love? What turned the hatred? What turned the hatred of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the heart of Khalid into the love of Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam? It was the good manners of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The good morals of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The good ethics of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. The one that Allah says about him, "وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ." Indeed, O Muhammad, we sent you a mercy to the entire mankind. We lack that rahmah in our hearts sometimes. We lack that rahmah in our hearts. We sometimes claim that we follow the Prophet, but we don't follow him in his entirety. We only follow sometimes what we like and we leave what we don't like. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart was for everyone. When the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fights against the people of Thaqif, the people of Taif, after he conquered Mecca, and the people of Thaqif were trying to kill the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and the Sahaba. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam besieged Al-Ta'if, and he puts a strong siege on the people of Ta'if for over 28 days. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lets go and walks away from Al-Ta'if to Medina. So one of the companions comes to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and he says, "Oh, Messenger of Allah, these wicked infidels, these wicked kuffar, the people of Thaqif, the people of Ta'if, that tried to kill us, make dua on them that Allah destroys them. Make dua on them, O Messenger of Allah." So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam raises his hand and says, "Allahumma ahdi Ta'if, Allahumma ahdi Thaqifan, wa ahdi Muslimin." So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will raise his hands after the man said to him, "O Messenger of Allah, make dua on the people of Thaqif." So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam will raise his hands to his Lord and he says, "Oh Allah, guide the people of Thaqif and bring them to me as Muslims. O Messenger of Allah, make dua on them. They tried to kill us. They tried to kill you. They fought against Islam and the Muslims. So make dua on them." So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he raises his hands and he says, "Oh Allah, guide the people of Thaqif and bring them to me as Muslims." This is what you call a prophet. And that's what you call Islam. And that's what you call Iman. An open heart to everyone. And me as a Muslim, I have a responsibility. My responsibility as a Muslim, the way Allah opened my heart to Islam, I opened my heart to everyone. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me to Islam, I want guidance for everyone. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought me to Islam, I want to bring everyone to Islam. This is the character of a Muslim. This is the character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not a harsh, aggressive, ruthless, rough character. ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لانفضوا من حولك. Allah addresses Muhammad and he says to him, oh Muhammad, if you were harsh with a harsh approach and harsh heart, your own companions will walk away from you. What attracted the enemies of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to become his lovers was the manners of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You could speak, you could debate, you could quote a lot of verses from the Quran, and you could quote a lot of a hadith from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but at the end of the day, words don't play a big role as much as the good manners does. Manners, my brothers in Islam. Manners, my sisters in Islam. Have the best of manners. Have the best of morals. And if you want to be with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hereafter, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إن أقربكم إلي منزلا يوم القيامة أحسنكم أو أحاسنكم أخلاقا. The closest ones to me in the hereafter, the closest ones to me in the hereafter are those with the best of manners and morals. If you want to know how close you are to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, look at your manners. If you want to know how close you are to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, look at your morals. If you want to know how close you are to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, look at your behavior. If you want to know how close you are to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at your discipline. This is your measurement. The closest people to me in the hereafter are those with the best of manners and morals. My brothers and sisters in Islam, our ummah has crisis in manners. We have crisis in manners and morals. We focus on a lot of other important issues, no doubt, but we'll also neglect important issues in our deen. And that's having the best of manners and morals. Sometimes we don't even have rahmah, mercy over one another. Sometimes we can't even tolerate each other. Sometimes we can't even accept each other. When Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Grab taut onto the rope of Allah. Allah commands that we all grab taut onto the rope of Allah. Collectively, united, together, and do not divide. These are the commands of Allah. These are the commands of Allah. That we together worship Him united. We together worship Him. Collectively. We together worship Him. And never divide. These are the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, and do not dispute. Do not dispute with one another. Do not divide. Or else, what happens? You will lose and lose your respect, lose your honor, lose that dignity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this ummah. All goes back to manners. All goes back to morals. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear what Allah azza wa jal had ordained upon us. Bu'ithtu lu'utammima makarim al-akhlaq. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, I was sent by Allah to complete and perfect the noble manners. I ask Allah to make us from those who have the best of manners. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشكره وهو الذي وعد المزيد لمن شكر. وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على النبي المعتبر. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد عباد الله، اتقوا الله فيما أمر وانتهوا عما عنه نهى وزجر، وحافظوا على حضور الجمع والجماعات، واعلموا أن الله أمر بأمر عظيم عميم بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه، فقال عز من قائل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الصحابة الكرام وعن التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. قوموا لصلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
In this world today there are many ways to fall from grace.